what went down here in a Boston Garden. The Animal now, after his favorite snack, the turnbuckle, he had something in his hand right there, Gene.
Oh, you can see it.
There it
That's
was.
It.
Went down, covered Tiger Chung Lee, got the 1-2-3 count. That's all she wrote, and you can bet your bottom dollar that the Chunger is happy to be out of this one. Another shot with that foreign object.
After the decision had been rendered by the referee, then look. George the Animal Steel goes to the turnbuckles, and Katie by the door, watch out. George Steel, your winner from the Boston Garden.
Can't believe, Brain, that you never tried to get the Animal to sign a contract to...
to sign a contract? I can't believe the way you and Mean Gene Okerlund sit out here and talked about what a great athlete this man is, and George Animal Steel. He used something he pulled out of his trunks, but no mention is made of that.
Oh, we mentioned
but
that one.
Oh, you know, but you don't elaborate on it. You don't think there's anything wrong with him doing it. You say, oh, he's not all there. Let him do what he wants. But some guy named 59919 gets out of the can, and everything's put on me. George Animal Steel is the one that helped the Steamboat. He helped Ricky the Dragon Steamboat become the Intercontinental Champion by pushing Randy Macho Man Savage off the top rope.
Well, now, just like Danny Davis helped the Macho Man originally right into Boston Gardens become the Intercontinental Champion.
Okay, you
want to
take
that? Forget about the foreign object that the Macho Man used in his match?
I never saw that. I wasn't there.
Against Tito Santana? I was there. I was at ringside.
Oh, I'm to take your word for it?
You don't have to take my word for it. It's all on tape. In fact, when you get your lawyers, you don't have to spare or spend any of your own money and take any depositions with me, because everything I've said about you is right on tape right here. We have it all.
I know it's a conspiracy. Everybody's been jealous of me.
Oh, my God. Is that
exactly the truth?
You should have made the comedy thing with Fuji and Morocco, because you're a funny individual. We've got the Islanders coming up in just a moment. I'm getting a little tired of you just belittling Ken Patera and how much his amateur athletic background did for him in his wrestling career. You don't have a clue what it's like to perform and do your thing in front of an international crowd, go to another country and have to do your thing like Russia and Turkey and Bulgaria, Czechoslovakia, Poland, Iron Curtain country.
I love to go to Poland and Czechoslovakia.
You wouldn't last five minutes there.
That's right, because they'd probably lose my luggage and I'd leave.
The Islanders, Haku and Tama, next on our program here. And don't forget, still to come, our feature, Dynamite Kid taking on Bret the Hitman Hart. But right now, this unusual tag team combination, the Islanders, as they take on two unlikely individuals, Spot and the Gladiator. What a crazy combination. No, I don't know.
At a total combined weight of 528 pounds, both men claim to be from parts unknown. Here is the Gladiator and Moondog Spot.
Do you think they're neighbors?
And their opponents.
I wouldn't be surprised.
At a total combined weight of 470 pounds from the South Pacific, here are Haku and Tama, the Islanders.
No, I mean, they're both from parts unknown. They might be neighbors, right?
Yeah.
Where is that city?
I'm not certain, Jesse. I thought maybe
parts unknown in Utah or parts unknown Nebraska.
I suggested somewhere out there where you live, somewhere in Hollywood. They have a lot of people out there walking the streets from parts unknown.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you this. Speaking of this, though, I've been receiving thousands of cards and letters from a lot of Vietnam veterans that want the body who's a fellow Vietnam veteran to say hello. So hello to all the vets out there, and I'm sure there'll be plenty of them at WrestleMania.
Well, what about this nonsense about Samantha Fox continuing to call you?
Oh, it's terrible. I mean, midnight, 2, 4. You know, I've had to call my publicist, my agents, and everything, and threatening her with fines. What else can I do?
Are you serious?
I'm dead serious.
So are the Islanders. Stern is tagging in. Haku Tama, look at that.
Move. Beautiful move.
The referee was counting with the wrong man. The illegal man in the ring.
You know, I like the Islanders' colorful tights, too, but there's a mistake. Haku just got caught in the corner. Or is that Toma? Which one's which?
That's not Toma. That's
Haku.
Tama.
Tama, Toma.
Toma was a lady wrestler. You remember her, Princess Toma?
Yes.
Oh, that's right. She dated Bruno, didn't she?
I don't think
so. I beg your pardon. Bruno's a very happily married man.
That's Tama now from the top rope.
Over the hip,
Tama.
You know, let's go back. Did you ever see such a despicable act of two guys patting each other on the back any more than Piper and Hogan? I mean, their hands must have got red, pounding each other's back and telling each other how great they are.
You're referring to the recent Piper's pick.
Piper's pick, yeah, that's right.
Well, I don't know. I mean, I'm sure things would have been a little bit different had you been doing the interview. You being a little bit different, huh?
I'd have told it like it was. I wouldn't have sat out there and pat each other on the back all night.
Islanders with a cover, count of two. Tag in from Moondog Spot. Haku and Tama. Working together.
Whoa. Caught one in each ear, I think.
Moondog Spot must be a robot. I thought that would knock anybody down.
I think he's out on his feet.
Moondog Spot.
There's a legal tag made.
Yeah. While holding Spot.
They better hurry to referee to count him out.
Whoa!
I think it's over.
It could be over, I believe.
No, he's picking him up. I believe that Islander could have pinned him.
Yeah, I'll agree with you there.
But he wants to dish out more punishment.
May have been watching a few old Jesse the Body Ventura tapes.
Why do you keep referring to old Jesse the Body tapes?
Well, I mean, it's a study, Jesse. I mean, here you've made the transition from the World Wrestling Federation into, let me say it. You went from semi-stardom in the wrestling world to semi-stardom in Hollywood.
No, I don't think so. I don't think so. You know, I got forced into retirement. Yes.
Why?
People like Joel Silver, Keith Parrish, them big executive producers, you know, they got a $13 million policy on my beautiful Hollywood face. I can't get in there.
What about the policy on the rest of your body? How much is that worth?
That's probably another 10 or 12 more. I can't get in that ring even if I wanted to. My hands are tied.
I don't know about that.
You don't see me run. You know, I'm not running away like Piper at the top of his career. I was forced into it.
I don't know about that.
You don't know much about anything.
I can sum it up. Oh my!
Whoa.
I know enough to know that's devastating. Tama with a cover. He should get him. No, I can't believe it. Gladiator kicks right up.
As time draws closer, McMahon and Bruno, do you feel the belt slipping from Hogan? As we get closer and closer?
I'd unfortunately have to say yes.
You think it's the last hurrah coming up?
Well, I just don't think that anyone can defeat Andre the Giant.
You might be right. For once.
Andre on his own. Wrestling on a scientific basis, undefeated in 15 years. Now that he wants to bend the rules, maybe even break a few, and has that no good Heenan in his corner, I don't know what a chance. There's no chance. I don't believe for any individual human being.
For once, I'm not going to argue with you. I think for once, you're on the right track.
Look at this. Right track, all right.
Ooh. One very impressive leap.
The winners of this contest, the Islanders.
The Islanders victorious. We'll take you back to the replay. And
Jerry Springs up on the top rope. Look, he must have shot up an extra 5 feet. And I mean, he came crashing down on a gladiator. And you know, he was going nowhere but staying down for that count.
Tama and Haku, the Islanders, victorious. We'll be seeing more of them for sure.
Well, Spotty and a gladiator didn't show me too much continuity, and they come up with the short end of the stick, but the Islanders are a very impressive team.
Well, you know, the Islanders are lacking just a couple things from becoming champion.
Yeah, like what?
Well, they don't have...
The belt, right? So they don't have the belt.
No. Would you like to answer your own question?
No, go ahead, but usually that's a remark that comes out of your mouth.
No, I'm going to speak very intelligently, like I always do.
Make sure we get a dub of this. Go ahead.
What they're lacking is the instinct to hate. See, they go out there, and they go through the routines. They've worked out constantly together. You can tell that. They're
it's
a
obvious.
Good, solid team. But they don't really care about hurting anybody. They'd rather pin you. They'd rather do some fan.